All right, so while we're waiting for the game to start, I just wanted to introduce myself. I'm Kylie Seigers. I play for the Overwatch team. And here today, I have Ella, who plays on the Valorant team. If you'd like to introduce yourself.
Hey y'all, I'm Ella and I play Valorant.
I know this game isn't like something everybody knows about. I'm still learning myself. So we made like little flyers with everyone's names. And also their main, so it'll help you with in-game knowledge. I will try my best to use their actual names because, of course, you guys are going to know their names as well. I appreciate all of you for coming, and if you guys ever have to pop out for anything, we are also streaming in Shelly and Rainy. So thank you. All right, so they're about to start, and I want to give some context on who we're playing today. We're playing Simpson College in Iowa. We went there for a LAN tournament, and it was a pretty close game for the Valorant team, so I'm excited to see how they play in the finale. So far, Cottey has went undefeated, though, so I'm super excited to see how they play. All right, so I was just notified that the stream was muted on your guys' end. I was giving some context on who we're playing today. We're playing Simpson College in Iowa, and we went there for a LAN tournament not too long ago where Cottey, for both teams, Overwatch and Valorant, took the win. It was pretty close though on Valorant's side, as Cottey has been undefeated so far. I'm really excited to see this game because it's going to be closer than what we've seen before. And today I have Ella Carlin here, who also plays for the Valorant team. And you can see her information on the pillar if you look at that and if you're down in Hink. And I'll have her introduce herself.
Hey y'all, I'm Ella. Yeah, I'm not playing today though.
But. All right, to give a little more context here, we have Cottey on attack and we have Simpson on defense here. So Cottey's gonna go try to plant the spike, which you can see on the top right of your screen. Gibson has it, and they're gonna try to plant it on site B here.
Hawk out.
Engage trigger. All right, so it looks like Simpson took the lead there, but Cottey's going to get a trade there with Gibson getting Atlas here. They try to fake that plant, but unfortunately get caught out by Simpson, leaving just Noob alive, I believe. Which is Lucy, if you look at the right pillar. And it looks like they're in a 1v1 standoff, but as Lucy goes for the plant there, Limco from Simpson is going to pick her off, giving Simpson the lead here. I will try my best to use their actual names. I'm very, very bad at that, but I will try my best. We have Buffalo Beanie here playing Raze, which is Amaya. Most of you should know her. She's on the flag football team. All right, and it looks like Gibson here has the spike again, and it looks like they're going to change their approach, however, and go site A here. If you look at the mini-map on the left, it kind of gives you a lot of information. Taking this awfully slow, but Limku is going to get the first pick on Ella there. And it looks like four of Cottey's players are going to go down quick there. And Simpson's going to have a flawless round, 2-0. Unfortunately, Cottey just cannot get the early picks there. What do you think about this so far, Ella?
Dang, that sucks.
I know when we played them, when we went to the LAN event, it was pretty close as well, so I know this is pretty tense for Cottey. And I would like to see them come on top of this, because they are undefeated so far. It looks like Gibson's watching that flank as the rest of the team pushes down mid. We're going to see Simpson Sky there kind of throw out her utility.
Her dog.
Her dog.
She let that dog out.
All right. Looks like Simpson's going for a pretty big flank here. If you look at the mini map on your left with Deadlock.
That spy carrier's down.
And unfortunately, spy Gibson's going to get picked off by Emerald Serpent, leaving Simpson with the advantage here. It looks like Ella just got caught out there, but Lucy's gonna...
One enemy remaining.
That is super unfortunate. They ended up getting a lot of picks there and taking that lead. I hope that was just some friendly banter from Emerald Serpent there, but we're gonna move on to Cottey's side of things again. And it looks like they're changing up their approach as Gibson doesn't have Spike anymore. And it looks like Ella's gonna try to go for the plant.
Yeah, usually I'm the one who plants Spike.
Yeah, we got Ella Carlin here, who we also call Junior. Usually plays Gecko, and he has a little buddy that will go and plant the Spike for you, which is super funny. But I don't think we're gonna get to see any of that today. And unfortunately, Lucy gets picked off early there. Super unfortunate. All right, and it looks like Simpson is up too, but it looks like Amaya's gonna maybe level out the playing field, which would be super good for them. All right, and it looks like it's a 3v3, but as soon as I say that, Gibson gets picked off. And it looks like from Simpson's side, we may be having someone come from the left-hand side.
Spread out.
Yeah. Looks like they're gonna close in on Cottey if they don't move quickly. We got Lick Dwarf from Simpson on the left, and Ella's gonna get that pick and even them out again. They move quick here, they should be able to get it and plant Spike, but I think they're gonna try to clear before doing that. Alright, Emerald Serpent knows where they're at, and we got their Deadlock from Simpson coming from the flank. Hopefully Buffalo Beanie is watching that, but unfortunately Amaya is not and gets picked off. Yeah. And that flank, it just goes to show you there that if you're not watching your angles, it can be pretty punishing.
Spike defused. Returning to post.
That looked like a pretty promising round for Cottey there towards the end, but unfortunately they just weren't expecting that deadlock from Simpson's side. Usually, if I'm not mistaken, and correct me if I'm wrong, Ella, but Cottey's attack is usually better than their defense.
Yeah, we usually get the plant really good.
Yeah.
I would say, yeah, our attack is pretty good most of the time.
Yeah. All right. And it looks like they're kind of going for a more split approach here as we got Lucy here kind of watching B while everyone else may be going for a late push on A. And it looks like that's exactly what they're going to do. They're baiting out Simpson to rotate, but it looks like their Brimstone is aware and is holding down A. Yeah, it looks like that's exactly what's going to happen. We're going to see an ult come out from their Brimstone, which can be super punishing if done properly, but unfortunately is not watching out, and Kuiper's going to get that pick on him, giving Cottey the lead on this round. And it looks like Amaya's going to get that pick on Emerald Serpent as well. You know, I think this was just what they were needing. And it looks like they're going to rotate, taking that TP. And they're going to plant on B here. But Simpson's well aware of that. And they're going to try to shut it down pretty early. Yeah, and it looks like they're leveling out the playing field. But Lucy's going to get a pick on Atlas, taking that advantage again. They got to get that spike, though. I wonder if Lucy knows where Limku is at, kind of giving you a Simpsons perspective. They got the plant. All they got to do now is just secure it. Oh, and Limku. Oh, Lucy's got to play this right if they want to take this round.
Nothing there.
Yeah, this is where I always fail.
This is super nerve-wracking. We got Limku checking their corners, and Noob's gonna give away position, not getting any shots there.
Joke's over. You're
dead. Oh, we're gonna see the ult come out from Lucy, and we got a flash, and Lucy is gonna take that victory for Cottey, leaving it in a 4-1. You know, that ult may not have been necessary, but I think it secured Cottey with that round win. Yeah. Just super good for them.
She got him with the flash.
And you guys
everyone cheered.
And I hear the support outside, which is super nice. We all appreciate you coming out and just kind of watching, even though you may not know the game. I barely know it myself, but Lucy here on Phoenix, if you don't know her ult, it basically makes her invulnerable to a kill for like a short period of time, and then she'll TP back to where she initially started that ult. I hope that made sense.
Yeah, she's got a little fake self that goes out.
And it looks like they're going to take the same approach here, kind of faking going B. And it looks like it's going to work again as Simpson kind of rotates. But we have someone take the TP. Amaya is going to shut them down, though. Emerald Serpent taking that TP was super, super risky, and it did not pay off for them. We still got Gibson over here, kind of alone, while all of Simpson is on A. This should be a relatively free plant.
Careful now.
They may end up taking TP to mid. Ah, and it looks like Lucy's going to get that pick on Atlas, giving them the lead they needed here. All right, and it looks like all of Simpson's going to take that TP as Cottey's going to set up for that post plant.
Got a deadlock from flank, though.
Yeah. We do have that deadlock again. It looks like she's trying to go for that flank. And they have got to be watching for this, for sure. Limku has been a strong competitor from... As soon as I say that, though, Limku is going to get shut down. And that's going to be another round victory from Cottey, which is absolutely huge. It looks like they're finding their approach and groove, and that is huge for them. I know it gets pretty tense in moments when teams take the lead like that, so I hope they're getting that confidence that they need. Wonder if they're gonna go for the same approach here. Simpson looks like they're kinda trying to figure out what Cottey's gonna do. Looks like we got 4 on A. And we got 1 on B. For Simpson. And it looks like they're rushing down. Alright, we got Kuiper there with the blind. And it seems like they know they should back off of that. And they're gonna trade, but Buffalo Beanie and Maya is gonna take the lead for Cottey here. And we got Kuiper here being altruistic and healing the team. As they're aware that most of Simpson is A, they're gonna probably go for site B here. And unfortunately, Gibson's gonna get caught out there reloading. Looked like he was trying to clear site, but unfortunately could not. Alright, it's anybody's game right now, and it looks like Simpson's gonna take that lead again. And is gonna get flashed by Space Dreamer Kuiper, and Kuiper's gonna punish them as they trade out there, leaving just a Maya to her own devices without the spike. The spike, if you look at the left-hand side on the mini-map, is kind of just sandwiched in between Simpson. And if you look at the bottom left, you're going to see Amaya's health, which is super low. It's going to be extremely hard to come back from this. And we're going to see a wall come up from them. Oh, Amaya with a flick, but unfortunately cannot get that. That was a super good round from both teams, but it looks like Simpson's going to take it, leaving it 5-2. I heard the initial excitement there and disappointment all too soon.
Anyone have funds to spare?
Alright, and it looks like we got Ella with a spike here. And it seems like they're gonna go for that split approach again. It seems to be working in their favor as Simpson's not able to rotate quick enough. Alright. Simpson may be... It looks like they may be knowing their approach now, though, because they're just staying on site. Kind of giving the illusion that no one's there.
They're just holding angles.
Yeah. I'm really worried. Oh. They're gonna get flashed out there. Now they know someone's holding that angle. But. Yeah. And it looks like Lucy's gonna clear that angle and is now aware of where Simpson Sky is at. Looks like we're gonna see some tension here from Gibson and their Limku. And Gibson, unfortunately, is not gonna see that in time. Giving Simpson the advantage. Maya playing it risky with that. What's that called?
The little robot thing.
Yeah. Honestly, okay. I don't remember. Lucy here. She gets a pick and evens out the playing field for them. But they're going to have to play it quick. We also saw an ult come out. And that ult barely saves Lucy there. Cottey is in the advantage right now. But they have got to play it smart. And unfortunately, Emerald Serpent is going to get 2 of them, leaving only Kuiper left.
One enemy remaining.
And unfortunately, I was really hoping Kuiper there would clean that up as he was playing extremely well. Again, from Emerald Serpent, I just hope this is some friendly banter as they are both really good teams. Yeah, Kuiper was playing that super well, but unfortunately, because of that smoke, could not see Simpson. It was super unfortunate. To give some more context on the game, this goes to 13 rounds, and if you look at the top here, they're 6-2.
Then Lucy gets caught with a double flash.
Oh, yeah, that's super unfortunate. giving Simpson the lead, but Kuiper there, unfortunately we didn't get to see that pick, but Kuiper evens out the playing field getting a pick on Simpson. And their sky is super low, so this is well within Cottey's ballpark. They just have to play this super smart. I'm worried for Alec here. I don't want to see her get caught out with a spike all by herself. And it looks like Kuiper is going to come to back her up. Being a team player. And we're going to see a flash come out. And it looks like Ella is going to take that TP to go for A. Understanding that B is just locked down by them. You know, if Ella... Oh, there's that plant that we're needing. And I think this is going to give Cottey the advantage. That was a super smart play from Ella there. And it looks like Cottey's going to rotate super quick so they can set up. This could still be anyone's round. Oh, and Gibson's going to get that flick on Dino Nuggies and cut him short. We'll say short. let's see. Atlas is super low. I've been worried about them for a while here. And it looks like Gibson is going to get that, and they're going to take that round and leaving it 6-3. That's super good for Cottey. You know, I think what really won them that round is understanding that B just was not the best option, and they took that TP to go for A. I don't know who called for that rotation on Cottey's side or if it was just Ella's intuition. But that was a really, really smart move from them. What do you think, Ella?
Yeah, and she used her ult there as well, so that really helped them out.
Oh, and it looks like Simpson is mainly on A. This may be the flank of the Sentry, as they are trying to go up behind them. Well, maybe not. They're going down mid, and I hope Amaya and Kuiper here that are also holding mid are well aware of that. Because if not, Simpson's going to get the catch on them, and that's going to be super unfortunate. And they are not watching behind them at all. They've got to move quickly, or they may get caught out there. Kuiper just barely escapes from their LOS, and they're all pushing up mid, being super silent. You know, I hope this placement from Amaya pays off, because they are all coming up from behind. Oh, and unfortunately, we see the ult come out there, but unfortunately, they just Amaya just cannot get any picks with it. That could have been huge for them.
They were all just standing there in the group.
This is still anybody's game. The spike is planted, and Lucy's going to get a pick there. Lucy's going to get a 3K, leaving just Lick Dwarf on their own from Simpson. This is well within Cottey's ballpark. They just have to hold down the fort, pretty much. Oh yeah, and Lick Dwarf, they know their location, and Ella's gonna get that pick. That was a huge play from Lucy, and they played that extremely well. I was super worried about that flank for Cottey, but it worked out. I'm sad to see that ult come out from Amaya, but that is A-okay. Alright, and it looks like we got Gibson here with the spike this time. He's been a pretty strong player this season. Everyone on the team has been, for sure. I'm super excited to see how they play this out. They're taking an awfully slow approach, which is often key in this game, especially against a good team like Simpson. And it looks like they're pretty much evenly split on both sides.
Here.
Alright, and it looks like Simpson's gonna rotate here, leaving just their deadlock on A to hold down the fort. And it looks like she may be migrating to the TP. And it looks like Lucy's gonna take the advantage for Cottey, and we're gonna hear her ult come out as well there. Oh yeah, and Lucy's gonna clear B here. Gets picked off, but we got that ult coming in handy there, and that's exactly what I was talking about. They're gonna get that spike down, leaving just the deadlock and brimstone for Simpson.
Last player standing.
Ah, and it looks like Lucy's gonna get a 4K this round. That is huge for them. Especially considering the fact that there is only 5 players on each team.
Last round in the half. 7 in 2 rounds.
Yeah, that is crazy. All right, so we are 6-5, and this is the last round before they swap sides, and we will start to see Cottey's defense. Cottey's attack has most notably been the best for them, I would say, especially comparing to the other games, but it has been pretty even for this round so far.
Yeah, and this is like one of the best maps as well.
Bind?
Yeah.
Yeah. If I'm not mistaken, the like little place here left of Kuiper is called Hookah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still learning my terminology. And it looks like Kuiper's gonna get caught out there. We see a little jump, but unfortunately, he just cannot come back from that. Looks like Simpson's trying to do the flank approach again, and they should be able to plant here, and it looks like that's exactly what they're gonna do. As Simpson's moving in for that flank rather slowly. I would say this is not the best spot for Ella to be, so I'm a little worried, and it looks like she's gonna get punished for it. That is super unfortunate. Had a little bit of foreshadowing there, but Amaya is gonna even out the playing field. All right. It's still a 2v2. It's anyone's game, but Cottey has the advantage with that spike planted. And as soon as I say that, unfortunately, Lucy is going to get picked off. Amaya's got to play this right. And I don't think, unfortunately, hearing that timer, it was enough time. It actually may have been, but unfortunately, because they got a halfway, it is not. That was a super huge game from both sides. And, you know, that deadlock barrier, if I'm not mistaken, that comes from deadlock. That almost actually ended up being super bad for Simpson's side. Still 7-5. This is anyone's game as it goes to 13, but looks like they're going to swap sides now.
Hold it.
Out of charges.
All right, and it looks like we're gonna get one of Simpson's players rather low. So it is slightly in Cottey's advantage, but as soon as I say that, unfortunately, Kuiper's gonna get picked off.
Down A. One enemy remaining.
All right, this is in Cottey's favor here. Oh, but Dino Nuggie's gonna shut down Lucy. And Ella's gonna avenge Lucy there, leaving Cottey with another win. That was a really strong defense from them.
You say something? Sorry, ears still ringing.
Thank you, Ella.
And it looks like we have relatively the same approach from Cottey. Defense is kind of rinse and repeat unless you're Simpson and want to go for that huge flank, but... Alright, and it looks like they light bought for Simpson. Probably didn't have enough funds to get any weapons that were pretty valuable. But it looks like they're going to go for a push on B here. Alright, and it looks like Cottey is aware of this now as we see one of their utility come out. Blinded. And we're gonna see a flash come out from Kuiper here. He's a super reliable Sky. And it looks like Simpson's dog is gonna get out on the battlefield there as Lucy gets a pick on their deadlock. Oh, and it looks like they're going for a rotation here to A. And it looks like Simpson is aware of this. We kind of see them rushing over on the minimap on the top left. And I don't think Cottey's rotation is quick enough to be able to get that plant. Oh, Ella with the picks there. She gets a 3k in no time.
Slay.
Yeah, that is huge. You know, I want to see Ella come out with a 4K here on Emerald Serpent. Oh, Emerald Serpent with a pick, but it looks like Kuiper, he's going to deny Ella that 4K. But leaving Cottey with the round victory there, leaving it to a 7-7. This is still anybody's game, and I'm super excited to see how it plays out. All right, and it looks like for Simpson, they're going for a split push here. Let's see. Yeah, and it looks like they may be going for Cottey strat here, where they kind of bait out on B and then push up to A. Cottey's smart. They'll see it coming, and I'm not too sure. Oh, and it looks like they're aware that they're going A for the most part, but that means that Kuiper... Oh, they're still holding B, though. They know the deadlock's there, so. All right, let's see. Oh, I'm super worried for Amaya here, but Amaya knows where they're at. Lucy's gonna get a pick on their Sky there, giving Cottey the advantage again. Oh, and unfortunately, Ella's gonna go down to Emerald Serpent from Simpson. And we're gonna see an ult come out from Lucy again. She gets those rather quickly. All right, and it looks like Simpson is rotating, and I hope they're aware of that. Lucy chased them down, well aware that her ult would teleport her back to where she was. Ah, Limco's gonna even out the playing field, but is just practically a sneeze from being picked off.
30 seconds left. Spike down, B.
And the spike is down, and Kuiper, he is going to make sure they're not getting that. He gets a pick on them rather quickly. Emerald Serpent looks like they're going to go for it. Oh, but Kuiper, he's going to shut them down, letting Cottey take the lead here. 7-8, that is huge. That is just what Cottey needed. All right, and it looks like we're coming back here with a timeout from Simpson. All right, looks like they're kind of rethinking their approach. Cottey's defense has been impeccable here, and it looks like Simpson is just not able to take that lead. So I hope they keep it up and they're able to take the round victory here. It's best out of three. So all Cottey needs is two wins. What do you think about the gameplay so far, Ella?
I don't know. I think it was great. It's great that we're coming back. Obviously, for my team.
Yeah. Never doubted it for a second. Cottey has been playing well this entire season. All right, and it looks like Simpson is going to go B here. They typically have been going A, but it has not been working out for them, and I think they're well aware of that. We could see a rotation, though, as Kuiper has been playing this extremely well. Oh, and we're going to get a blind there, letting Cottey know that they're pushing B.
Kuiper's a demon on Sky.
Yeah, he is. All right. Ooh, and Gibson there is going to get the early pick on Atlas. But Lick Dwarf is going to even it out. Oh, we get... Oh, that was a nice spray from Kuiper through the smoke there.
Love when that happens.
Yeah.
Spike planted.
All right, and it looks like Kuiper was trying to use the smoke to his advantage there to get that barrier down. Amaya with the pick on Limco there. And Lucy with the pick on Lick Dwarf. All right, and it looks like they're going to completely clear out Simpson, and all they needed to do is defuse the spike. And it looks like that's exactly what they're going to do. And Cottey is going to take that win with the team ace. That is huge for Cottey there.
Make sure to follow my pack in. They'll lead us right to the enemy.
If you're unaware,
I think so.
Team ace means that everyone on the team got a kill, an elimination,
if I'm not wrong.
If Ella's not wrong. We may be completely telling you the wrong thing, but that is okay. So Ella here, Cottey got a point. So you're gonna click a point.
Sorry, I just got promoted to scorekeeper.
Yeah. Alright, and Cottey's going for the same defense approach, and it looks like Simpson is gonna push site B again here. Their deadlock is holding that corner real good. Alright. Let's watch Kuiper again. He's been playing extremely well. We get a little bit of spray out there, but no damage from him. And while he's reloading, he gets caught out by the other guy's dog. And Amaya is gonna take out their deadlock. Ooh, Amaya with the 2K here. Alright. I almost saw a grenade come out, but... Ooh. Alright, we got that Viper ult out there. And yeah, it looks like Atlas is gonna shut down Amaya real quick. Oh... Gibson with the pick there, but he's gonna have to move quick to get that defuse. Last player standing. Yeah. And I think... Yeah, and unfortunately, they just... That Viper ult there really saved Simpson, giving them that victory. That is super unfortunate for Cottey, because they were playing that super well, but they could not see through that smoke, unfortunately. Alright, and it looks like Simpson's gonna go for the same approach here since they got that last lead. That last win. I don't know why I said lead. Just ignore that. Alright.
Talking is hard, okay?
Yeah, it really is. Oh, and Kuiper is well aware that they're going B. So I hope that Cottey rotates pretty quick here.
Got that information as the initiator.
Yeah.
Sky.
Alright, and it looks like Simpson's gonna rotate to TP here. But Lucy and them are kinda on the flank by mistake, but it's gonna give away position really quick there. And that's super unfortunate. Lucy's gonna get picked off there as well as Ella. Oh, and as soon as Buffalo Beanie's ult comes out there, she gets picked off. This was a really good round for Simpson, but... Ooh, go for it with the 2K! This is still anybody's game. Alright. It looks like Cooper is gonna get that flash and get that pick. That was a nice flick from them. All they have to do is defuse now, and it looks like it's relatively free. Unfortunately, though, that Viper's gonna come up behind Kuiper and get that pick. Gibson has got to play this extremely well for him to be able to get it. And it looks like he's going to get that defuse. That is crazy for Cottey there, taking another round victory. Gibson played that really smart there. It's kind of hard to know what to do. Usually they will fake the defuse, but I think staking it there really gave Cottey that advantage.
Goes here.
Yeah, Gibson's kind of goaded on Cypher, too.
Yeah, Cypher?
He only started playing Cypher pretty recently.
Okay.
Not started, but, like, playing in our games.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, Cypher got buffed, so he's, like, a better agent now.
Awesome. Alright.
So did Gecko.
All right, and it looks like Simpson may be trying to bait them over to rotate to B. And, you know, I think that's exactly what's going to happen. I think Cottey's well aware, though, and is going to keep two on A, which I think should play in their advantage here. Toxins going up. We're going to see a wall come out from Ella here. Oh, and Ella, unfortunately, is just out in the open and gets picked off by the other Viper. All right, and we're going to see Lucy go for this quick rotation. You know, Simpson is just kind of all over the place. It's kind of hard to know what to do here. All right, and they're going to try to go for that plant.
Spike planted.
We have a Mai on the flank here. I wonder if that's going to end up paying off. Limco is super low, and Gibson's going to get that pick. Oh, bomb body out from the Rays on the enemy team. Oh my goodness, so much is happening, but they're in a 3-3 standoff with Simpson and at the advantage here. Oh, and we're going to hear that Brimstone ult come out, and they're going to get a pick on Kuiper. It's still anybody's game. And it looks like they're just going to leave Gibson there all by himself. And that Viper is going to take that victory for Simpson with a 4K there. That is super unfortunate for Cottey. But that ult from the Brimstone really won Simpson that round. That was super smart on them.
Gun here.
Now, it is very possible we could go into overtime because in Valorant, if I'm not mistaken, you have to win by 2 points.
Toxin screen down.
Pretty sure. Is that not it?
It could be 12-13.
Could it?
But, like, if we both get to 13, then it's overtime.
Ah, and Lucy's going to get that early pick, holding that corner extremely well. And it looks like all of them are B, but Cottey is still on A, unfortunately. They better hope that Simpson... Oh, and we're going to see a double rotation here. I don't know if you paid attention to that minimap, but Cottey just took the TP to go B, and Simpson went through the teleporter to go A, leaving just Gibson to hold down the fort. Oh, and he's spraying in, getting a little bit of damage on that raise. And it looks like the rotation and Gibson holding it down was in their favor.
One enemy remains.
Oh, Buffalo Beanie with a 2K from her ult there. And if you don't know, Buffalo Beanie is a Maya. I keep saying their in-game names, but just to give some context, Simpson here left with one person, but he does have the spike. They've just got to play this well.
10 seconds left.
All right, if they just hold down sight, they should be fine. Oh, Dino Nuggies with a flick, but Gibson is going to clean that up and is going to give Cottey a gift of winning another round there. That is super good for Cottey. This has to be nerve-wracking on their end.
Did Ella get disconnected? She reconnected.
Yeah,
yeah, she moving. I got a little scared too.
And they're gonna get the ult orb there, and it looks like their sky is ready for ult here. We got Noob and Space Dreamer holding the same angle. Probably hoping for one to peek just so they can get that elimination really quick.
Yeah, you can see at the top the agents who are highlighted, those are the ones that have their ults ready.
It's a really good insight from Ella Carlin here. I could not have told you that. So, thank you. All right, and it looks like Simpson's going to go for a rotation here to A. And Cottey is well aware of this, so they are trying to get over there as quick as possible.
30 seconds left.
Oh, and unfortunately, Gibson cannot get that pick, but Ella is going to even out the playing field. You know, if Ella sprayed in that smoke even a little bit, she probably would have got that pick on them there. Lick Dwarf is half health. All right, and it looks like all of them are finally on site. All right, Lucy with a pick on Lick Dwarf, who is half health. They're going to try to go for the defuse there, and it's going to get halfway. And Ella rightfully got off of Spike there. It's still their game. Oh, but Lucy flashes the wrong way. But it looks like Cottey is still going to take that win. Buffalo Beanie cleaning them up, also known as Amaya, to give Cottey that round win. It is match point, and it is in Cottey's ballpark. Their defense has been super good here on those super quick rotations. Simpson really wants to fake them out, but it doesn't seem like it's going to happen. We're going to see a new approach from... Oh, and unfortunately, Amaya is going to get stuck in Deadlock's cocoon. If you don't know, Deadlock on the top of the screen is the Limku just died. And that ult will...
Spike down A. Last player standing. Defenders win.
All right, and it looks like Cottey's going to take that victory. Unfortunately for Simpson, they played that extremely well on defense, so I'm excited to see how they play the next round. It is best 2 out of 3 again. It was super good for them. All right, and as we take a break here, if you need to use the restroom, get a snack, take a drink, anything like that, we appreciate you for coming out and supporting. That was a really good round from them. All right, and I didn't get to mention the scoreboard here, but you're going to see Noob Lucy on the top here with an average combat score of 354 and 28 eliminations. That is a crazy stat.
She's actually here with us right now.
Yeah, and it looks like she's going to leave, unfortunately.
Dang.
But you can see here everybody's stats, which is super good for them. And we can also look at the timeline and just see how many wins they took. That is super crazy for them. And again, thank you so much for supporting us. All right, it looks like we're coming back here. Cottey took the lead on the last round, as a reminder, and we're going to be playing on Haven. We may see some agents change here on both sides, and it looks like that's exactly what's going to happen. We have Limku from Simpson going Killjoy instead of Deadlock. You know, this is a pretty tense game for both teams, as this means, like, they will win the bracket. And I hope, for Cottey's sake, that is them, because so far they have been undefeated, which is a huge achievement for them. And again, here I have Ella Carlin, who is also on the Valorant team.
Hey, guys.
All right, and I'm going to start off by explaining the characters' names for Simpson. At the top on the left side, we have Raze, Sky, Killjoy, Omen.
That is not Harbor.
Atlas, we don't know yet. I'll just call him Atlas.
Oh my god, I totally forgot.
And Breach. He's Breach. They have the names right there. We can't read. That is okay. And for Cottey's side, we have a Cypher, Phoenix, Raze, Sky, and Brimstone. Relatively similar approach as last game for Cottey, but
with the difference of Brimmy.
Exactly. All right. And it looks like Cottey is going to be on attack first here again. Which it seemed like their defense last time was super good. Alright. And if you look at the top left on the minimap here, you can see that there's three different sites where they can plant rather than two. Which is super interesting. For me personally, I don't like that, but, you know.
Yeah, me neither.
It's just a little more stressful. Alright. It looks like their breach there is gonna have a little earthquake, kind of to stun them. All right, it looks like they're gonna go for a rotation, even though it looks like they thought about A. And Emerald Serpent knows where they're at now. We're gonna see their KJ, number 3 on the minimap, rotate. Oh, and it looks like Lucy knows where they're at. Smart to rotate here. We're going to see a smoke come out from Ella. Yeah. All right. And it looks like Simpson's well aware of their rotation. And there's going to be a lot of picks on the right-hand side, but it's still anybody's game. And it looks like Cottey is going to take that slight advantage with that spike plant. All right. Now all they have to do is just hold it. And hopefully that they do that well. They're all playing back, kind of maybe baiting them out. I'm not sure where they planted. Oh, and here we get to see it. Wow, it's kind of out in the open, so if they try to go for that defuse, Cottey very well could punish them for that. All right, and we're going to see a fake, and Gibson is going to get a 2K there, leaving it in Cottey's ballpark. Oh, and Kuiper's going to get that final pick on Lick Dwarf, giving Cottey the win there on the first round this game.
I'll teach him to respect their elders.
Now, I'm not too sure how often Cottey plays on this map, but I'm sure Ella knows. If you'd like to let us know.
So we don't usually practice this one. Gibson was just telling me, we mostly have only really done, like, Swift plays. So this is not exactly in our favor, but that's just how the picks go.
Yeah.
Each team picks, you have your picks and your bans for the maps.
Okay, so good to know.
They picked this one, I believe. Simpson.
Yeah.
That was a little spooky for Gibson there. We're going to see a stim beacon come out from Ella. And Gopher's going to kind of look if there's anyone on site. They're going to get that plant early on before Simpson can even fully rotate. That is huge for them. You know, Cottey played that really smart, and their post plant should be a breeze.
Cage triggered.
And it looks like Cottey only took a little bit of damage if you look at the top right. So they just hold their corners, this is a free round for them. Oh, and it looks like Lucy and Gibson on the right side are gonna get two picks, and Amaya here is going to clean up Simpson. You know, I don't know if Simpson's too familiar with this map, and they may very well be, but it looks like Cottey is taking the advantage here. You know, I haven't seen Cottey play this map before, so it's super interesting seeing their approaches to varying maps. Kind of helps me learn a little bit more about the game myself. All right, and they're being awfully slow about taking any steps, really. Trying to decide on what to go. Alright, and it looks like Lucy is aware of someone being there. Maybe saw a little bit of Limku. I think that's how you pronounce that. I'm not too sure. But, alright. You know, both teams are kind of dispersed here. Cottey's looking a little unsure with just 50 seconds on the clock. If that runs out, it's an automatic win to Simpson. Maybe they're trying to bait the omen here on C so Ella can get that plant, but I'm not too sure. Oh, and Gibson kind of gives a little peek at Emerald Serpent, but they're not going to get that pick. But because they're playing this so slowly, this is going to allow Simpson to rotate. Ah. But even with that quick rotation, Cottey is going to get those picks and clean them up pretty quick. And Lucy may go down there, but that's still another Cottey win. And this has been really good for them. It's great to see how I was worried about that slow approach, but it paid off for sure.
Now Lucy has a spike. Oh, now Gibson has a spike.
Yeah. Lucy does not have the spike anymore.
Yeah, she like never plants.
No. Yeah. Lucy very much is not someone who is stationary. She seems to initiate most of the combat from what I've seen. All right, and it looks like Simpson coming from the left is going to go for a quick flank here, but Gibson is well aware of that. As we see some utility from Simpson come out, kind of giving up their positioning. Oh, and Gibson is going to take some shots there. He knows Atlas is there, but unfortunately cannot capitalize. We're going to see a trade come out, but now Simpson is in possession of that spike. Cottey cleared sight extremely well, but it looks like they're just going to hold their angles here on spike. It's going to be super hard to get this back.
Joke's over.
We're gonna hear Lucy's ult come out here, and I think that's gonna win them this. Oh, it may not. This is anybody's game.
One enemy
and it's just 1-1, and I think Lucy is gonna take this as he has 5 HP, and that's exactly what's gonna happen. And Cottey's gonna take another win. You know, I think that ult there from Lucy really saved Cottey that round. If not, that would have been Simpson's. Cottey's been playing this map super well, even though, from my understanding, they're rather unfamiliar with it from the competitive scene. They've been playing this extremely well, and that ult very much saved them on that last round. We're gonna see Lucy struggle a little bit here to get that turret down, taking a little bit of damage, and Atlas very well could have picked her off, but that is not what happened. Lucy is extremely lucky to get out of there. All right, and it looks like we got the omen from Simpson going for this flank again. They seem to like those. Dino Nuggies is going to pick off Kuiper in the top right here. Just super unfortunate. Right, Ella's gotta hold those corners, and Noob's gonna get that pick on Atlas. Alright, they gotta watch out for those raise bombs. Alright. Hopefully they know about the flank. I'm a little bit worried about this. Hoping that flank doesn't give Simpson the advantage, but it very much could. Alright, and it looks like Simpson's aware that they're rotating C. I think that omen gave them knowledge of that rather than trying to go for a pick.
30 seconds left.
But super smart on them. We're gonna see Lucy's wall come up, giving them some time to plant. It looks like Lucy is gonna hold corner. She's gonna get flash, but they're not gonna be able to capitalize off of that. We still got Emerald Serpent trying to get that flank, but Gibson is going to get that pick. Lucy with the pick on Limco, but Licked Dwarf is going to get her as well. There's a lot happening on the top right there. But Cottey still has the advantage, and Ella's gonna get that pick on the raise. That's gonna leave Cottey with another victory, 0-5. This has been a huge round for Cottey. They've been playing this extremely well on attack. Alright, and it looks like Simpson's gonna take a timeout to maybe reevaluate their strategy here. So during this like 60-minute time, if you want to get like another slice of pizza, take a restroom break or anything, you may as well do that. Again, I appreciate you all supporting. And if you have to step out for anything, we are streaming in Shelly and Rainy as well. So I appreciate your guys' support. Is there anything you'd like to say, Ella?
Slay. That's all I ever say.
Give you a little look at the scoreboard here before they start pushing sites. And we got Emerald Serpent on Simpson's side at the top here with their ults right ready. And then we got Noob Lucy on Cottey's side here. And we got Amaya's ult ready as well for raise. I hope that timeout is what Simpson needed to maybe kind of reanalyze their gameplay. Noob's gonna get concussed there and get picked off by Emerald Serpent. That is super unfortunate. Lucy just got caught out. But, you know, Buffalo Beanie Amaya is going to avenge Lucy, and they're gonna go for that rotation, which is what I think they need. Hopefully they're watching for Dino Nuggies here and watching their corners. And it doesn't look like they are quite well, but they're gonna get a lot of trades out there, leading it to a 2-2. Cottey still has the spike, though. We're gonna see Simpson in the top left rotate quickly to A, understanding that's exactly where they're gonna go. And Kuiper is gonna take that lead advantage and get their KJ out early. And unfortunately, trying to use that utility for Gibson there kind of catches them out. You know, I think if Kuiper here plays it slow, this is another Cottey victory, but you can unfortunately cannot get caught out like that. I think waiting and trying to bait out that fuse would have been the way to go there, but unfortunately that is not what Kuiper did. Love Kuiper, he's been playing extremely well, but I think just waiting there and being patient was the play.
Turret out.
What do you think, Ella?
Yeah, I'm the exact same way. As a person who has started playing Valorant pretty recently, I'm not very good post-plant. So that is definitely one of my flaws as well.
You know, I get a little greedy. I want to end that round sooner rather than later, but being patient post-plant when it's a 1-1 is super important, because Simpson has to make a move on that spike, but Cottey did not there. Alright, we're hearing a little bit of fire out from Gibson and Ella here. Doesn't look like they did any damage, but they did open that doorway. Alright. They're taking it awfully slow again here. Alright. Seems like they're struggling knowing where to go. And Kuiper is kind of in a 1v2 here. And he knows he's in trouble. So he's gonna kind of retreat, get that blind. Kind of delaying their push there. And I think that's what he needed to get out. That was super smart from him. We're gonna see some smoke come out from their Omen. Alright, but Cottey is planted on B. You know, I get worried about planting on these mid sites. Because you can easily get, like, kind of sandwiched in. Alright, and it looks like they're gonna trade there. Oh, Limku with the 3k. And it looks like Simpson is gonna take that round again. They played that super well. It kind of forced Cottey to plant on B. I always get worried about those mid plants.
Come on, get me in the line of fire.
All right, we got Gibson here, giving Ella the spike, and it looks like they're gonna go for C. I think Cottey's slow approach here has been paying off extremely well. When they seem to get in those, like, more tense, quicker situations is when they start to fall.
Joke's over. You're dead.
All right. We're gonna hear Lucy's ult come out here. And... it looked like she was gonna use it to take down KJ's beacon, but...
KJ's ult.
Yeah, KJ's ult, but that's not what's gonna happen. And they're detained, meaning they can't use any abilities right now. Yeah, and that's gonna last for a while. This still could be anyone's game. Cottey has the spike in their possession, but they have got to play it smart. Lucy holding that corner is what saved her there. Alright, it looks like they're going to go for a quick rotation. We're going to see some smoke come out so they can get that plant. And, that breach, like, earthquake there, I think is exactly what Simpson needed. They have got to play post-plant smart here if they want to win. Alright, we got the flank from Emerald Serpent, and Ella's holding down that flank.
Last player standing.
Oh, but unfortunately, Emerald Serpent is just going to get the upper hand there. Lucy at the back there, kind of behind Ella, where she passed. Ooh, it's gonna be super hard for them to come back from. Oh, Lucy with a pick on Emerald Serpent. And that is super unfortunate. They're gonna get that defuse, and Simpson is gonna take that round again. You know, I think that timeout is exactly what Simpson needed. I don't know how they're changing their approach, but it seems to be paying off extremely well. As they're in a 3-5 score here. Alright, and we're gonna see their breach here. Got another earthquake. It's gonna get concussed, but they're not gonna be able to capitalize on it. Alright, Limku with the pick on Lucy super early, leaving Simpson at the advantage, and it's gonna allow their Omen to rotate if you look at the top left map. I'm worried about Cottey getting sandwiched here again. And we're gonna see the dog come out, but Kuiper's not gonna let it happen, and is gonna get that pick. It's gonna punish Dino Nuggies for that. Alright, and we got Omen on the flank again here. He seems to really like those, but Cottey seems to be aware of it. They're gonna go for that rotation, but Omen may get a pick here. I'm not too sure. They're gonna get concussed, and they're not gonna be watching that flank, and Emerald Serpent is gonna get a pick on Amaya there. Ella's gonna quickly clean that up, leaving them at a 3-3, and they're gonna get that plant before Simpson can rotate. This is well within Cottey's, like, ballpark. All they have to do, again, is just watch and play post-plant extremely well. Everyone is fully healed for both teams. Oh, and Gibson's gonna get that pick on their raise. Oh, we're gonna see an ult come out. And it looks like Ella's gonna get a pick on Atlas there.
She used her ult.
With her ult, yeah. That was super good. I think using that ult there helped Cottey secure that victory, leaving it a 3-6. You know, I hope that round win was exactly what Cottey needed to keep that confidence going. They play extremely well. I just think sometimes with the pressure and stress, they can kind of fall.
This goes here.
It stresses me out watching them sometimes.
Stressful playing.
Yeah, I bet. Alright, and it looks like the Omen is alone here. Emerald Serpent. And they're gonna get taken... Little Camera's gonna get taken down pretty quickly. They're gonna spray through. And Emerald Serpent is gonna get out with, like, a speck of health. Simpson is rotating to kind of help him, but Lucy is gonna get that pick. Ah, Atlas, unfortunately, with the pick on Lucy there. Ooh, we get a little bit of... You have a lot of assists there on that pick from Ella. Alright, and they got the spike down. They just have to play this well post-plant. Again, it's out in the open, so it's easy to defend. Yeah. Simpson's got three players, but Cottey's got four. It seems Site C has been most beneficial in securing Cottey a victory for the round, so I hope this plays well for them. We got Dino Nuggies here, and...
One enemy remaining.
Yeah, it looks like they're just leaving the KJ here. And Buffalo Beanie Amaya is going to get a 2K there, finishing them off, giving Cottey another round win. That is huge for them. Amaya has been playing really well, getting those double eliminations back-to-back. That is crazy. Looks like we got some chatting going on here, asking for someone to buy. All right. And it looks like Cottey has found their rhythm again, which is super good. They're taking a 4-round lead. Alright. Got Gibson kind of holding the flank here. If you don't know, the things here are throwing out are tripwires, if I'm not mistaken. And when someone steps into them, they do what, Ella?
They announce your presence.
Yes. Make your presence known.
I think they stun you as well.
Alright. Looks like Ella's gonna get that pick, and we're gonna see Kuiper here being altruistic, giving Ella some health back. She was super low, so... Gotta thank him for being a team player there. That's what this game is literally all about. But,
so true.
Yeah, so true. So true. Alright. Ah, and unfortunately, Kuiper just didn't look stable enough there to get that pick. I tend to move around when trying to get those picks as well, and it looks like that's what happened there. You have to be very stationary when trying to get those picks, otherwise your gun sprays a lot.
Yeah.
And it's not going to leave you with the advantage for sure. Alright, and it looks like Ella's going to get that spike planted in the open. And again, Cottey just has to play for post-plant. We're gonna see Breach's Earthquake come out. Ooh, Amaya with the pick, but gets picked off by Lick Dwarf as well. It is still anybody's game, but Cottey has the lead here. They just have to wait.
Last player standing. All right. One enemy
remaining. Oh, Gibson on the flank. Oh, and unfortunately, Gibson cannot clutch that in. Simpson is gonna defuse Spike. That was a really close round. I was really hoping that flank would pay off for them, and it almost did. That was smart from Gibson.
Last round before the switch.
All right, and this is the last round before the switch, so they're going to be spending all of their funds. I know I haven't touched on this a whole lot, but the credits can be seen in the bottom right, but unfortunately, because of our overlay, yes. You can't see that, so ignore that.
that goes there.
But, alright, and it looks like Cottey is going to go back to their roots and go for Site C here. It's been working out for them extremely well, because Omen has just been left there alone. That was super scary for Emerald Serpent. We're going to see Lucy's ult come out here, and she's going to clear Site, allowing them to plant. You know, we're not planting yet, which is a little worrisome. I hope they get that out soon. Because they're still 5-5. They've got to play this well. Oh, Lick Dwarf with a pick there. Oh, a lot of picks from Simpson, leaving it 4-2. I think Lucy's ult may have came out a little early there.
One enemy remaining.
Oh, we get that spray through the smoke, getting Ella. That was entirely luck. That is super unfortunate. That's going to leave Simpson with another round win.
Dino Nuggie's got the flank on Lucy.
Yeah.
Switching sides.
I think if Lucy held her ult there and saved it for a time, that it may have benefited them more, but I understand the rush to use it, because once you swap with your rounds, you don't get to utilize that anymore. Just unfortunately, the only person who was there was Omen, and they were not able to catch him out. So we're going to swap sides here, and we're going to start to see Simpson on attack and Cottey's defense. Like I said, I haven't seen Cottey play on this map a whole lot, so I'm not too sure what their strategy is here. Of course, they're going to like split up on the sides, but I wonder how they play on this map.
Yeah, they're having Gibson set up his traps and stuff on C.
Yeah.
Cage triggered.
All right, and it looks like Simpson's going to go C. We have a tripwire triggered for Gibson. And I hope Cottey rotates quick. Gibson's going to get an early pick. It looked dwarfed down super low, but that spray through the smoke just catches him out. It's super unfortunate. Limku with the pick on Buffalo Beanie. Simpson has the advantage here, but Lucy is going to even it out. All right. Lucy's going to reload and check her corners, but unfortunately gets caught out because of it. All right. Ella knows that Dino Nuggies is low.
One enemy remaining.
And she's going to get that pick. She's got to play it right, though. Oh, that KJ is just going to spray through the smoke. Oh, and Ella's going to get that pick and give Cottey another round win. Ella played that extremely well when she saw that spray coming through the smoke. She would have stuck it. She could have easily got picked off there. Ella played that extremely well to give Cottey that advantage.
Shut and lock the door.
Got a little bit of jiggle peeking here from Kuiper. He's gonna get him. All right.
He's ready.
Nella holding mid here.
Smoke's
down. Too sure what Simpson's doing here on the minimap. They look a little confused. It may just be going for a slow approach, though. And it looks like they may be pushing for Site A here. I think that's exactly what they're going to do. So we're going to watch Noob, also Lucy here, and see how she plays it.
Behind
her. Yeah.
Smoke's down.
All right, Noob put the pick on Atlas pretty early. You know, I think that may be what Cottey needs to get it. Oh, Ella was scaring me a little bit with that spray, but gets a pick on Limco. Ella with the 3K, and we get to watch that unravel. Ella's been playing super well these past few rounds. Props to her. I never doubted Ella for a second. That spray was amazing. Ignore my comment on that. You knew what you were doing. All right. So it looks like they're going to go for the same setup here. And it seems Simpson is going to try to push C instead of going A. It looked like they tried to go for a late push, but that did not play to their advantage. All right, we kind of have KJ alone here setting up her turret. It's a nice turret. All right. All right, so it looks like they're going to go for a quick push on C. We're going to see Amaya. Ooh, go for the pick even while he's blinded. And Amaya's going to get that pick down on Atlas, C. Leaving Spike down at C. Oh, Ella with the pick again, but it looks like Simpson's going to get a 2K. And kind of even it out. We got Lucy's ult coming out here. Oh, and she's going to get that pick. All right, she's going to TP back, and this may give her the advantage she needs.
Got your trail.
Oh, it looks like we're gonna see an ult come out here from Dino Nuggies. Alright, so Dino Nuggies is well aware of Lucy is, and this is definitely in their favor. It's gonna get flashed, but not for long. Lucy has got to take it slow. Oh, and that is huge from Lucy. That is exactly what Cottey needed to take that round. And they're gonna defuse here. That is crazy for Cottey. Alright. You know, that round looked really promising for Cottey, but I got a little worried at the end there. Alright, and it looks like we're gonna get another timeout from Simpson. You know, I'm curious if they'll start playing as well as they were after that first timeout. They really picked it up, and I believe they got like three rounds back to back. Well, what have you thought of the gameplay so far, Ella?
I'm hoping there's only three more rounds because I have an essay.
All right, yeah. Just a little reminder of the finals that we all have to do. So, yep. Yippee.
Do my 10.
Yep. Oh, goodness. You're pushing it. All right.
That's what I do.
All right, we'll give a little look at the scoreboard here. We have a Emerald Serpent still at the top for Simpson. And then we have Lucy at the top here for Cottey as well. Ella's ult is ready. Super excited to see that come out eventually. It's as much explanation as I'm going to be able to provide you with. But all right. It looks like the round is going to get started here. Let's see. Ooh, it looks like Cottey is taking a new approach. Hey. They're all on. Hey. We got three on B.
Your brimstone. Nobody on A.
Let's go. Nobody's on A, and it looks like Simpson is going for A. I really hope this plays out in Cottey's favor, but this looks a little intimidating.
Some of them are going to A.
All right, looks like they know that they're rushing that, and Kuiper, he's gonna rotate quick. All right, we're gonna see his big dog come out. He's gonna miss it though. That is super unfortunate. I did not know that Flash could go up and over. Gibson with a pick on Lick Dwarf. Ooh, Kuiper with a pick on Emerald Serpent, shutting down their top player. That is huge for them. This looks super concerning for Cottey at the beginning, but this should be easy for them. Kuiper with another pick there, and Ella is going to clean them up with an ult. You know, I was excited to see that ult come out, and it did. I don't know if they exactly needed it, but it did clean up that round for them.
How's that for a plan?
It's better to use it and get it out there than to hold it the whole time, so. Overall, that was a really good round for Cottey. Leaving it 5-11, they only need two more rounds for them to take the victory in the finale, if I can talk.
Grand champion.
Yeah, and they'll become grand champion, so I'm super excited to see this. Last time when we played Simpson at the LAN event, it went 2-1, but it looks like it may go 2-0 here.
Launching smoke.
Cottey taking the lead. All right. We're going to see Lucy here get an ult orb. She's still 3 away, but looks like Simpson's going to go for B. I know when I play on this map, B is never my first pick, but it looks like we're going to get some trading in there. Dino Nuggies with a 2K, leaving Simpson in the lead. Alright, it looks like they're gonna rotate A. I'm a little scared for Lucy, but I don't doubt it for a second that she'll get a pick. And unfortunately, she's not. I spoke too soon. I really should not be jinxing them right now. Alright. So, Simpson's gonna get that plant on A here, leaving just Amaya and Gibson. They've got to play this smart. Gibson going on Heaven. And that was a really nice flick from Gibson. Ooh, Amaya with the pick on Licked Dwarf. Amaya with the 2K evening out. All right. All they have to do now is defuse and get the KJ. Cottey. Oh. Limku with the pick on Gibson. Amaya with the pick. Is she going to be able to defuse in time, though? She's got a 3K here, and I think she's going to have enough time to defuse.
Yeah, there's all a right. certain point. It's like, I don't remember exactly what it is, but it's like when the circle
match
like
point.
Shows up, that's like the last time that you can start the defuse
okay.
and still get it.
See, I didn't know that.
Yeah. I don't remember exactly what it is, but.
All right, and this is match point for Cottey, leaving it 5-12 for Simpson. You know, this is all they need to win the championship and be undefeated. They have played a huge season, and I really hope they take this. Oh, and it looks like Emerald Serpent is going to get an early pick on Kuiper, but Cottey is going to rotate quickly, understanding that they're pushing A. Oh, we're going to see the attacker Killjoy come out here. And we got to see that in play last game. Okay, Lucy's going to get out of there, but still within range of that Killjoy. And she's going to get detained. If you look at the... Yeah. That KJ ult really just... kind of hinders your team. We see the Omen from Simpson, TP. Oh, and I thought Gibson was going to get that pick, understanding that he was back there, but Emerald Serpent's going to get a 3K off of him. Yeah, and it looks like Emerald Serpent's going to get a 4K. Limku is going to take that ace away from him, though, giving Simpson another victory. This is still well within Cottey's ability to win. And I'm super excited for them. I know it has been a nerve-wracking season prepping for this game in this moment, so I'm super excited
right
to see how this round has played out.
Oh, this is a nice spot. This goes here.
All right, we're gonna see a tripwire come out from Gibson here. It's kind of locking down C, and I think that's the smart thing to do here because they are all going C. And I hope Cottey realizes that we're kind of seeing them push down mid, maybe going for that flank or pushing back up into C. We get Buffalo Beanie with the pick, but unfortunately gets shut down. And Simpson's going to take that lead as the rest of Cottey is going for a flank here. You know, I hope this pays off for them. All right, we got Limku here, full health. Ella's going to get a pick on Atlas, and Noob's going to shut down Limku. This may be the round that Cottey takes the championship on. They just have to play this well. Emerald Serpent with a pick on Space Dreamer. Oh, and it's left in a 1-1 with Lucy. Lucy has got to play this right. This could be the round they win, and it is going to be the round that they win the championship on undefeated. This was a huge, Ooh. Huge game for Cottey, and it looks like they're going to beat their score against Simpson from last time at a 2-1. They played that game extremely well for never playing that map at all. That is crazy. All right. And as Cottey wins there, we can see the scoreboard here. Here's some cheering outside. We appreciate you all coming out and supporting for sure. And we're also going to see the timeline. And it seems like the team's going to be coming out here. All right. Thank you so much. All right, and as they take that win, I'm going to wrap up the stream. That was a super exciting game from them, and I appreciate everyone coming to support who's down in Hink, Shelly Club, or Rainy, or just someone from back at home. We really appreciate your support this season, and it is super exciting to see them win this championship after working so hard. Thank you so much again. Have a good night.